Good morning, students. Hello and welcome again. Last time in accountancy, we have seen interest on capital wrongly calculated. Today, in the same chapter, chapter number 2, partnership account, we are going to see the most important topic of the chapter. I repeat my lines again, the most important topic of the chapter. You know, students, in 11th standard, you have seen final account. Final account means trading account, profit and loss account, and balance sheet. That was 11th standard. Partnership form is 12th standard. 11th standard, we have seen the accountancy of individual business sole proprietorship. In 12th standard, we have the account related to partnership and company. So, while preparing the final accounts, apart from trading account, profit and loss account, and balance sheet, we have to prepare few additional accounts, extra accounts, and that we are going to discuss today. Trading account will be same as we were preparing in 11th standard. Profit and loss account, there is no change, and then balance sheet. But in between profit and loss account and balance sheet, two extra accounts we have to prepare. One is known as profit and loss appropriation account, and one is known as capital account. Sometimes, apart from capital account, we may prepare current account also, but that depends on information given in the question. Right now, we are only going to discuss about profit and loss appropriation account. Students, profit and loss account we prepare, then after we are going to prepare profit and loss appropriation account, third number. Now, what is the profit and loss appropriation account? Appropriation, in our local language, we call it as their adjustments. But here, appropriation means the information which is only related to partners. Students, listen here. Interest on capital. Interest on capital, normally we were writing on profit and loss debit side just because it is an expense. Now interest on capital is related to a partner. So instead of writing in profit and loss account, we will write down in appropriation. Side will be same, debit side will be there, but thus the account will be changed. One more thing I would like to say, suppose a partner salary is there, it will be recorded in profit and loss appropriation account debit side. But if any other person's salary is there, then it will be recorded only in profit and loss account. So we can only say that profit and loss appropriation account is separated from profit and loss account. Profit and loss appropriation account is separated from profit and loss account. Now we have to see few basic fundamental rules of this account. Let's see. Profit and loss appropriation account. It is almost like a profit and loss account. I can only say it's not almost like, but it is a part of profit and loss account. In profit and loss account, debit side, all the expenses are there, and credit side, all the incomes are there. Similarly, in this account also, debit side, all the expenses are there, and credit side, all the incomes are there. But the next important point here is, information relating to partners will be recorded. Means, any information which is related to a partner will be recorded in this account. Other than partner, only one or two items are there, like say we can take like capital reserve may be there, transfer to reserve fund may be there, two or three things can be there, manager commission can be there, which will be recorded here. Otherwise, 98% items which are related to partner will be recorded in this account. Other than partner, other information will be recorded in profit and loss account. Next, debit side expenses will be there and credit side income will be there, as I already discussed. At the end of the account, when you do the total, suppose if credit side total is more, it will be considered as divisible profit. I repeat again, it will be considered as divisible profit. And if debit side total is more, it will be considered as divisible
loss. Now, once this account is closed, the divisible profit or divisible loss will be transferred to capital or current account. If you are only preparing capital account, then directly in capital. By chance, if you are preparing current account, we transfer this profit or loss in current account. Your question may be, when to prepare capital account, when to prepare current account? It depends on the question given in the sum. Now suppose if question indicates you have to prepare current account, you have to prepare current account, otherwise capital account is the final one. After capital account, balance sheet will be prepared. Thank you very much. Have a wonderful day.